you all are doing good and welcome back to Quality Management Series. A big thank you for your overwhelming response towards my channel, towards my videos. And you know, it's very glad to know that people encouraging themselves towards quality improvement, continual improvement, and keen to learn something new every day. So it is highly appreciated. And moving towards our topic, it is all about the sentinel events, their types, how we're going to analyze them, how we're going to report them, and what are the policy goals. I mean, how are we going to create that policy by using that goals, right? So without wasting any time, let's begin with our topic.
I have given the basic guidelines on preventing and managing sentinel event as per an NABH standard. These guidelines are applicable to all the hospital. Apart from the basic guidelines, there are some other specific requirements which will be different for different hospitals. So, as we all know that the patient safety is the core concept of NABH standard, and it's the hospital responsibility to define sentinel and non-sentinel events. So now we are going to talk about the sentinel events, any unexpected incident related to system or process deficiencies which leads to death or major and enduring loss of functions are identified as sentinel events. So to identify these deficiencies, make a list of these events, and the list must be available to all the concerned staff and should be reviewed periodically. Okay. So this basically includes loss of functions referred to sensory, motor, physiological, psychological impairment, right? So the hospital should make a protocol for preventing all the adverse incident from taking place, and the preventive action should be very well planned and implemented. And it's for your hospital to decide how you will categorize the event and monitoring them. Okay. So now moving to the types of sentinel events. First is surgical events, which include wrong surgical procedures performed on wrong patient, patient death during or immediately post surgical procedures, anesthesia related event, device or product event, which includes serious disability associated with the failure or breakdown of device, intravascular air embolism. So patient protection event include patient suicide and self-harm. So environment even includes a burn, slip, trip, fall, electric shock. Care management even include maternal death due to low risk pregnancies, medication error, omission error, and criminal even include abduction of a patient and sexual assault. Okay. So now moving to the next slide about the difference between these two. I have already told you about the sentinel events because they signal the need for immediate investigation and response. The term sentinel events and error, they are not synonymous because not all the sentinel events occur because of an error, and not all the error results in sentinel events. So occurrence of both will result process failure. So now we discuss about the non-sentinel events. These are those which do not cause any harm to the patient. In this case, the patient are not going to affect it directly, but somehow they might be affected indirectly. For example, biomedical equipment breakdown, damage, theft, lift failure, or any malfunctions related to equipment, right? So for reporting system or any kind of adverse event, your organization should have multidisciplinary quality control committee. And this committee should be in charge of monitoring all the adverse events taking place. And apart from this, the hospital management should equally involved in managing and monitoring these events, right? So you must retain proper record of action taken to correct or minimize the harm caused to the patient. So train all the staff in handling these events so they can take necessary corrective and preventive action immediately after happening. So at the same time, verbal reporting should be done immediately. Okay. So moving to the next slide, here you can see the image that how the organization is going to manage such events if happens, right? So basically there are three main steps, and first one include the source from where it happens, then immediately manage the condition of the patient. So secondly, your organization has to arrange the minutes for discussion. Okay. So Now, for reporting of the events, you need a standardized format. So what are the basic content that covers the entire event? Now I'm going to tell you this. The details of patient, location, date and time, adverse incident category, detailed description, root cause, kappa, outcome of action taken and follow-up for implementation. So this should be presented in MRM. Okay. So moving to the other slide, it's the NABH requirement that all the processes should be defined and documented and implemented. Therefore, you have to define, document and implement the method for capturing and analyzing the sentinel and non-sentinel event. So here are some goals of sentinel events policy you can read. So thank you for today, and please like, share the video and subscribe to my channel. So till then, bye bye.
So whatever you learn from this channel, just go and implement that in your organization and then analyze the trends, okay? And if you really find this content useful and informative, please do like, share and subscribe to my channel. We will meet in the next video. Till then, bye bye, take care and stay safe.